the biggest beater in America. There she is.
David's ride truly defines the classic beater car, complete with a very incomplete list of parts.
But he does have one wild toboggan of a hood with a high-rise air filter to go along with it.
Well, by listening to David and seeing the car, between what he wants and what he needs will probably all add up to a lot.
The A-Team is excited about this project because Hot Rodder David is clearly the kind of driver who wants his car to be wild.
But right now, it's wildly in need of first aid, and that's exactly what it's going to get here at Kayser Compressors.
It'll get all that and more as we start work on the result of our hunt, having bagged the biggest beater in America.
It's 8 p.m. on day one. Car just got back from media blasting. The bad news, A-Team found a lot of rust. The good news, it's only day one.
You ain't messing around.
It's a beater now, isn't it?
It's day one, about to roll into day two. So we're fixing the rust, we're fixing the dents, we're doing some body modifications, filling the door handles, filling some side markers, all that stuff needs to get done.
And it will get done.
With the guys from Kayser manning the deck lid, the rest of the team works the beater into suitable submission, all before David's very eyes.
Oh, it's come a long way in one day, I tell you. It really has. It doesn't look like the same car, and it's not the same car.
No.
If David figures it's not the same car now, wait until he gets a load of it 7 days from now. That car will not be the same car beyond even his wildest imagination.
It's 2:30 in the morning, day two. We're done with the metal work right now. We gotta get some rest. No rest for the wicked.
There's no rest for the wickedly talented, as Foose figures it's never too late to pick up the pens and redesign a ride. And this ride is gonna be wild.
David said he wants his Camaro to be powerful and noticed. And if anyone can deliver all that, it's gotta be Foose.
The owner also said he likes Candy Apple Red and Midnight Blue. So with those two colors on board, there's gonna be a hot rod in the works before we know it. Chip gets started on the intricate graphic layout he's designed, taping his plans onto a donor car to be transferred later to David's ride.
This method will save a lot of time in the long run.
Once the graphics are on this car, then we actually will lay paper over top of this. Then you take a pounce wheel, which is a little wheel with spurs on it, and you put holes in it. And then with chalk, you can take that piece of paper once it's done, put it on the other car, and then pounce that with a little chalk. It'll put the little dots on the other car, and then you can tape right to those dots. So what I might spend 4 or 5 hours on this car, laying the graphics out, when it's time to put the graphics on the other car, I can transfer it and have all the tape work done in about maybe an hour.
And he tumbles off with a brilliant plan afoot. He also knows that once he gets one side done, he's completed the whole car, since the paper pattern will simply flip over to get the other side of the ride flamed as well. It's work Foose hits until the wee hours of the morning. Okay, Sean knows what he needs to do. Make this Camaro crazy with color, starting with that very bright yellow. Foose's design is going to require many finely sprayed layers. It's the only way to convert Chip's wild concept into a real and flamed up masterpiece.
Looking at Chip's design, it's amazing how much of Sean's yellow will be buried under all those forthcoming layers.
Now we're gonna put on the third and final orange, which is the darkest color, and it's gonna be heaviest at the front of the car, transitioning back into the yellow at the end of the car.
The yellow and orange layers are a base that will now play host to Chip's elaborate paper patterns, showing Sean where all the flames go.
Chip perforated this paper. Everywhere you see the lines, there's actually real small holes. We're gonna lay it out, use a couple reference points that he marked on it, then we're gonna rub some chalk through it. The chalk's gonna leave a faint impression on the car, and that's what we'll follow when we mask it off. I'm gonna start from the bottom of the car so that my clothes don't rub off the chalk as I'm leaning over the vehicle.
These lines have got to be put on just right if they have any hope of becoming the flames that the good Chip Foose intended them to be. The great news in all this, Sean here is a master painter, an artist who likes a real challenge. Well, young master painter, if there ever was a challenge, this is it.
6:45, day 7. Still putting color down on this thing. We have to mask off in between the flames so we can spray the blue. Sun's coming up. We need to get this thing done fast.
Yeah.
Okay, everybody calm down. The kid is a pro, and he's making with that blue like there's no tomorrow, because actually there's not. Anyway, once he gets that on, he only has, oh, a few more dozen layers to hit. No biggie. We'll just have to miss our deadline for the first time in show history, that's all.
My backup just arrived.
Two painters, that's good, right? Like, maybe they can each take a different color and, well, I guess that would get a little messy. However they do it, we gotta know that two guys are better than just one guy. And if they're both spraying, we just might have a chance of pulling this whole thing off, right?
Here's the deal. The thing started as America's biggest beater. Of course it ate up a lot of our time. And with this radical paint job, well, we knew it wasn't gonna be a walk in the park from day one.
But with the tape now on and the red now flying, we could have a real shot of getting this back to David when promised. And time-wise, to get that 572 in there with the rest of the installation, we'll just have to move faster than we've ever moved before.
Look, David's an understanding dude. He gets his car back a day late, a week late, no problem. We'll just humiliate ourselves and tell him we goofed up.
Hey, nobody goofed anything up, because it now looks like this paint job is almost completed.
There it is. We did it in 27 hours.
We're all pretty stoked about David getting his car. So without any more delays, it's time for the moment of truth.
You ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
I just wanted to check.
I don't know, Chris. Don't mess with Texas.
All right, man. Whenever you want to turn around, go for it.
Oh, my God.
Pinstripe's wet, David, so just don't streak those.
Oh, my. Whole front end here, too. Oh, man. Gorgeous. Oh, I can smell it. Oh, man. Oh, look at the seats. Oh, man, those are gorgeous. And you left it standard, didn't you? Oh, man. Oh, look at the instruments. You know, it smells like a new car. Oh, my God. I mean, it's a work of art, it is.
It's a work of art that speaks for itself, saying a lot by simply arriving. This is now a car with a little thing called presence. And when David goes down the street, they'll notice a few dozen miles away.